Hey family, it's Marv, onerepatatime.net, new exercise tutorial video. Today we're going to go over the dumbbell goblet squat. So what I'm going to do is explain the setup, the proper execution, coaching tips, mental cues, all of that stuff. And then what I highly encourage you to do is grab a lightweight, do one of your warm-up sets with me, and even replay this video while you're doing your working sets. And this is one of the first time you've done this exercise and you're not really feeling confident or competent yet that you're doing the step-by-step instructions that we're going to give you. So squatting in general, a lot of people have a question of what should be your natural stance as far as the width and placement of your feet. Here's what you're going to do. I want you to jump up and down three times with me. So one, two, three. Now, typically, wherever you land, which for most people will be a little bit outside of shoulder width or hip width, if you landed and you felt stable, like really secure on your feet, that is your squat stance. Now, if my feet are pointed directly towards you to goblet squat, I want your toes to be angled about 25 to 30 degrees out. I mean, don't get like crazy nitpicky over, but just have, you know, your toes angled outwards. So when we do the goblet squat, what we're gonna do is we're gonna have a dumbbell. We're gonna hold it here. So when we squat down, our knees travel outwards and our elbows tuck inside of our knees in the bottom, and then we come back up. So we sit down into a squat, knees are out wide, elbows are tucked, and we come back out. Now, before we get into the actual coaching tips on that, let's talk about squatting in general. When people first start squatting, a really common, I guess, mishap in the beginning is people will start to kind of fold over in half. So yeah, they're squatting, but really, they're really just folding over in half. That's what we don't want. What we want to have happen is when you're in that bottom position, you can read the front of your shirt if there is a mirror in front of you. So why do people fold in half? Well, first and foremost, their low back is really weak. There's also some mobility issues going on, especially with their hamstrings, with their hips. That's why those daily mobility drills that we recommend are so damn important. That's why a proper warm-up is really important, especially for squatting, especially the 90 and 90, the POCA stretches, the hamstring stretches, the leg swings. It's really important to do that, so do not neglect that when you're getting ready to squat. All right, so now that we know that we want our chest up, what else should we do? Well, when we come down, what's awesome about the goblet squat is you'll naturally find your natural center of gravity, but when we're coming out of the hole, this is the hole when we stand back up, I want you to drive up through your heels. So again, we fall down in the hole, drive up through your heels, and here's the biggest tip of all, the biggest takeaway. When you're driving up through your heels from coming out of that hole, I want you to spread the floor with your feet, so there's going to be an outside force. Now, I'm exaggerating right now, I'm making my knees move willy-nilly. But guess what? That outward force will actually prevent your knees from caving in, which is really common if you have weak quads. So we want those knees to be staying outwards. We don't want them to cave in. So that spreading of the floor will actually prevent your knees from caving in. And for lack of a better word, it's activating your side butt muscles, and it's really getting a lot of tension in your legs. So wherever you are right now, let's just do a bodyweight squat with that cue. So we drop down into the hole, drive up and spread the floor with your feet. See how much tension you have in your lower body? Let's do it without spreading the floor. Drop down into the hole, drive up. Now let's do it with spreading the floor. Drop down into the hole, drive up to the heel spread. That's the type of tension we want you to carry. And last but not least, breathing. Now you can take a breath in on the way down, so. But what I'd rather you do is get in the habit of breathing that's going to be necessary when you transition to a barbell squat, if that is something you're looking to transition to. So that means you almost like take a gulp of air, like really expand your diaphragm, fill it up, brace your core. So drive up, spread, exhale. That will just get your core nice and firm and rigid. When you transition to having a barbell on your back or the front or even a Zercher squat, your core is being embraced, so it's gonna help you perform those properly. So let's grab that light dumbbell, ladies and gentlemen. Let's do your warm-up set, potentially your working set based on how much you need to put you through the step-by-step. So we get that. For most folks, like I said, just slightly above shoulder width stance, toes pointed out. Get that dumbbell right where we want it. Let's take a big breath in, sink down, drive up, spread, breathe out. Big breath down, drive up to the heel spread, out. Breath in, Big goal. Drop down. Spread. Drive up. Good. Couple more. Drive up. Spread. Drop down. Drive up through the heel. Spread. Couple more. Drop down. Drive up through the heel. Spread. Two more. Drop down. Drive up through the heel. Spread the floor. Big goal. Drop down. Drive up. Spread. Exhale. Last one. Drop down. Drive up. Spread. And there we go. So, goblet squatting, that's how you do it, one rep at a time.